to talk to you guys about how bachata hype started, where we're from, how bachata originated, and throughout the whole thing, we'll be singing little pieces and snippets of the songs. Don't be weird, at least you're gonna walk around. All right, so somos un barrio in New York, se llama Washington Heights. De ahí que viene el nombre Bachata Heights. En realidad, when we were coming up, growing up, Washington Heights was a bad neighborhood. It had a lot of drugs, violence, gangs, and la verdad que la música para nosotros es una forma de terapia, a way to keep our minds busy, la mente ocupada en algo positivo. Y creo que más por eso nuestros padres, our parents, siempre nos apoyaron. Even though the neighbors would call the cops on us almost daily, nos llevaban la bocina, nos llevaban la guitarra. But we would never stop, we would never give up, we would always want to keep going. Pero before we fell in love with bachata, it was for a reason. Growing up in New York, en la escuela siempre escuchábamos hip-hop, R&B, the typical stuff in New York. We were raised around a lot of different cultures. Pero every time we would go home, we'll listen to bachata because our parents would play merengue and bachata. And in 1993, I don't like seeing the years. They seem old. But in 1993, salió un bachatero que se llama Raulín Rodríguez. I don't know if you guys are aware of him, but Raulín Rodríguez is one of the old school, one of the pioneers in the modern day bachata. And in 1993, salió his first album. And there was this one song called Fue Como Un Viento. So we're going to sing it a little bit just so you guys can know what we're talking about.
Fue como un viento que vino del mar y todo llegó. Fue como un sol que bajó del cielo y todo quemó. Ya nada queda de nuestro amor, tu vida y la mía, todo se acabó. Coge tu camino y yo cojo el mío. Que seas feliz con tu nuevo amor, mejor que yo, mejor que yo, mejor que yo, mejor que yo.
So in reality, esa canción changed our lives. We were listening to that song so much, I think we ruined it. En ese tiempo, I don't know if CDs even existed yet.
Don't say that.
No, he's saying the story how it is. Y we played it tanto que my father actually bought the tape. Y lo estábamos tocando every time. He'll come from work tired, como a las 5, las 6 de la tarde. And he'll say, Concho, me van a hacer odiar la bachata. Because he went from loving bachata to hating it. Because every day we were playing this. And it wasn't like the whole CD. We were playing this one song over and over again.
Y era la de la cinta.
Exactly. So we had to rewind it. And this song changed our lives to the point where we wanted to learn how to sing bachata, play guitars, play the bass. Y en el grupo, us four, yo y Jonathan, the lead guitar, we're brothers. Con Diego somos primo hermanos. Y con Chino nos criamos junto desde niño. We were from the same block.
Todavía somos niños.
That's true.
Well, yeah, so then from then, Jonathan, he wanted to learn how to play the guitar, so our family, they've always been into the music, so un día de nosotros le regaló una guitarra a Jonathan, y ahí fue que Jonathan aprendió a tocar la guitarra, and then we were the younger cousins and brother, so we were like, wow, like, you really learned how to play the guitar, that's cool.
I signed that instrument.
So then he was like, you know what, let's make a band. You're going to be the bass player, which... That's what I am today, the bass player. He told Jay, you're going to sing. And then he told Chino, you're going to be coro. And then we have other cousins that they were like, Bongo. The ones that didn't want to stay with Bachata Heights anymore, so we got to replace them. So that's when Bachata Heights was born. But it wasn't Bachata Heights. We named the group Los Maestros del Mambo.
Eso era muy viejo para nosotros.
Yeah, so then everywhere we'll go to like perform somewhere, people be like, oh, yo pensaba que eran viejo que venía. Where you guys are maestros from? And we're like, oh, we're the maestros del mambo.
In Washington Heights.
Yeah, so then we decided to change the name in
98-99. Because in that time, it was actually una comunidad. It still wasn't so common for the youth, the young kids, to love bachata and play bachata on the streets and the cars. And it was Alcoa es una comunidad de young bachateros that are from Dominican descent, but we were all born and raised in New York, but our parents were Dominican, and in the Bronx estaba Grupo Aventura at that time, and in Washington Heights, it was Bachata Heights, and there was a group in Brooklyn, groups in Queens, and we all kind of know each other. Henry used to go to our house before they were big and famous. Steven from Extreme también venía a la casa de nosotros, so we were all like a little community of young kids that just fell in love with bachata, and they were able to get to the fame first, but we were all like excited and happy because we all came up from this thing that wasn't common. It wasn't common to be a bachatero, especially young from New York to do it. And we were always with the mentality like, we want to be independent, we're going to do it on our own. Pero the years were going by and we see that Aventura makes it. Extreme started getting the buzz and they're doing good. And then we were like, you know what, we're just going to have to sign whatever contracts, because we were getting a lot of offers, but we never wanted to actually sign. Because you know how they say, be careful with the first contract you get.
Then we got screwed. And that's what happened.
So I guess we got so desperate for it, we signed the worst contract in the world. Pero, como todo, hay que siempre sacarle todo lo positivo a todo lo negativo. And in that first album, which was the first label we were with, salió la canción, Me Puedo Matar, which I think some of you guys know it. So we're going to sing a little back up and then we'll do the whole song with the music. Okay. Pero ayúdenme a cantar. Si se la saben, dice.
Tus sentimientos te dominan cuando tú me dices que te vas. Y reclamas tantas cosas y me dices que nunca hubo paz. Incluso dices que me odias y que no me quieres ver más.
Sentimiento, mami.
Pero de repente todo cambia, te hago falta y me llamas para atrás. Y todo vuelve a ser normal y tengo miedo porque te amo más. Será un infierno, te confieso, si algún día tu decisión se afina.
Y el coro dice...
That
was the first song that actually opened the doors. Thank you. That was the first song that opened the doors to